Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I am part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we will cover the most common problems faced when working with ESP32 and the ways to solve them. The most common issue you might come across while working on the ESP32 is when your ESP32 is not detected in the port option of the Arduino IDE. It might be one of these two problems. It can either mean that the USB drivers for your board is missing or that the USB cable is not compatible. Let us look at how to solve the USB driver problem. First, take a closer look at the serial interface chip, which is usually next to the voltage regulator of the board, and then check its name. If you can't read the chip's name, then go to the official schematic diagram of the board and try to find the name of the chip using this. Now go to Google and type in the name of the chip followed by USB driver download. In our case, this chip is CP2102. Download the USB driver and then install it. After the driver is installed, restart the Arduino IDE and you should see the COM port in the tools menu. Even after this, if the issue persists, then you should check whether you are using a proper USB cable. Some USB cable used for charging devices doesn't have data wires in them. Thus, using a proper USB cable should solve your problem. Another common error that can come about while working with the ESP32 is a failed to connect to ESP32 or a timeout error while uploading the code. This happens to many newbie tinkerers and even experienced people when they forget one crucial step. The error happens when the ESP32 is not in flashing or uploading mode. Now to solve this issue, you must first make sure that the correct board name and the COM port are selected. When your sketch is ready and you are ready to upload, make sure that you keep holding the boot button on your ESP32. Then keeping the button pressed, press the upload button. After you see the connecting message in your Arduino IDE, release the finger from the boot button. Now the code will start uploading without any hiccups. In most of the boards out there will be a dedicated boot button. But to make it more user-friendly, some versions of the board will automatically handle the boot mode and the execution mode based on the operation. SparkFun ESP32 thing is one such ESP32 board. Now let us look at some of the errors that can come in the serial monitor and see how we can solve them. Sometimes the ESP32 will be printing weird text or gibberish messages in your Arduino IDE serial monitor. If this is the case, make sure that you have the right COM port selected and have set the right baud rate as you have configured in the code. In most examples on the internet, 115200 baud rate is normally used. Let us look at another serial monitor related error for the ESP32. When you open your Arduino IDE serial monitor and the error message "Brownout detector was triggered" is constantly being printed over and over again, it means that there is some sort of hardware problem. Any of the following reasons can cause this: poor quality USB cable, USB cable being too long, board with some defect like bad solder joints, bad computer USB port, or not enough power provided by the computer's USB port. The solution for this will be to first try different shorter USB cables with data wires. Then you can try a different computer USB port, or even use a USB hub with an external power supply. We have now covered the most common ESP32 problems and solutions to those problems in this video. That is all folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.